Hi everyone. In this video, I want to talk about steady state and dynamic process models. In particular, we will talk about the key differences and go through a couple examples to ensure that you understand. Let's first talk about our favorite thing in the world, steady state processes. These do not fluctuate at all with time, such that if you measured something now versus 10 minutes from now, it'll be just the same. These can be extremely useful in design calculations. But what about a dynamic system? Well, dynamic means constant change, so our measure, whatever that may be, is constantly changing or fluctuating with time. These are much more applicable to real-world engineering applications, even where you may not expect them. Just for an example, let's imagine you are operating a piece of machinery that is operating near steady state. But to account for an added order, you need to increase production quantity. Well, the machine is going to have to adjust to your new input step, which we have been talking about in the previous few videos. And as you can see here, in between our two steady state regions, we have a dynamic region. In addition, many systems typically look pretty crazy with time like this. And that is why control systems are needed to mitigate and fix this crazy line so it more closely approximates a constant value. So now that we have an understanding about the key differences between dynamic and steady state models, let's look at a few time to output graphs to make sure we really understand. Just take a second and pause the video. Give yourself a try to figure these out on your own, and then come back and verify that you got the same answers as me. So, in this first graph, we clearly have two regions of interest. The first region is clearly steady state, as our output does not fluctuate with time. However, in the second portion of the graph, it clearly is changing with time, and is therefore exhibiting dynamic behavior. Let's move on to graph number two now. Clearly, there are no regions on this graph where the output is not constantly changing, and therefore, this whole region is dynamic. Lastly, let's take a look at graph number three. If you find it easier on these types of graphs, you can denote where important changes occur, like so, and this will help you visually dissect each region. Since region 1 and 3 have no fluctuations, they are both steady state, whereas in region 2, there is oscillations occurring, so this region is dynamic. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding about the key differences between steady state and dynamic systems. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.